What's up, Wraeclast? Wabachai here with two great guests today, Ziggy D and Mors Rage NG, or Mors. What's up, guys?
Hello.
Awesome. So today on What's Up, Wraeclast, we're not going to be doing multiple topics. We're going to be doing one specific thing. It's going to be trade. Trade chat. Get it? We're doing trade chat. Ha ha, funny. Okay.
Time out. Joining global trade chat.
Yeah. Leave global chat. We're in trade chat right now. And I want to start off with saying that one of the biggest things that got me into Path of Exile was the nostalgia from Diablo 2 and the barter system and trading. And as it's turned out, it has not translated well into Path of Exile. At least that's how I feel.
Translated too well into the future.
It needs to be updated. So
a more correct statement.
Yeah, exactly. So what do you guys, you know, Ziggy, what are your thoughts on trade in Path of Exile, just kind of in general?
Just to make a massive topic into a one sentence answer, sure. Yeah. How would I sum up my thoughts on trade? I'm not happy with trade. Like for quite some time now, I've been a proponent of saying, like, in the last expansion, I was like, this is GGG's chance. They need to do something big with trade now with this set of changes, because there's going to be so many players flooding in here, so many returning players, and they may not rejoin for another expansion in the future. Like, so I thought last expansion was like a really big kind of point for them. Probably a good thing that lockstep and loot filters and stuff like that turned out to be very much good enough that it did bring a lot of extra players back and bring a lot of new players into the game and keep them there. So we kind of did okay without trade improvements, but I'm definitely thinking that for this next expansion that we're going to need some. And thankfully, the devs have said that there's some trade improvements coming. My thoughts on the extent of required trade improvements is the question for debate, because I definitely am of the mind that there is a point where it could become too efficient and it could be of a detriment to the game. We have people asking for like trade overhauls and massive trade improvements, and I don't know how far I want to go with that. I'm glad that GGG is taking an incremental approach. So that's kind of where I'm at now as a bit of a summary, but I'm sure we'll kind of talk more through it over the course of this show.
Yeah. You know, it's funny that you say that, because one of my issues with trading is just the fact that as it stands right now is that you say how efficient is too efficient, but really the barter system requires active participation from players, and the third-party tools that we use, while great when you know how to use them, does take out a bit of that active participation. It does, I feel like it kind of hurts it a little bit more than it may appear. So, but what about you, Mors? Like, how do you
feel?
Well, okay.
So I think Ziggy did a really good job of summing it up. So I would almost just dive into kind of just keep what we're talking about. And very central to it is you see, and I'm sure it occurs in every country. Of course, I'm America, so I only know American, but companies pay for extra time to make trading. Like when they, you know, oh, there's going to be a shortage of oranges, and they find that information out, you know, 0.1 millionth of a second faster than everyone else does, so they can do their high volume trade, whatever. And we see right now this sort of stuff going on with PoE, where there's this durian program, which I just started using, and I guess there's some private indexers, and I don't really know enough about all this stuff in terms of the nitty gritty, how the server architecture works, and you know,
you mean
pulling
you're not
the
scanning people's inventory for mirror drops,
right? Whatever the hell that all that stuff was about. But clearly, but clearly, people are able to grab. You know, I've listed Taste of Hate at 3x because I'm a newbie, and because I see them sometimes. My durian will ping me new item found, and I'll go to whisper the person it's already been sold. So, and he's not like, oh, I just, so I'll ask, oh, did you just sell it? Like, as we're talking, no, I sold it 3 minutes ago. So I feel like, and that is refreshing basically as often as XYZ, or what is it now? PoE, sorry, I still call it XYZ, PoE.trade.
Okay.
And same. Okay. So I feel like something that they would do is better for everyone involved, just in terms of leveling the playing field, so people don't feel like they're being out scooped all the time. And out, because if the third party you know, is the wave of the future for GGG. Whatever they do to improve that, my hope is that they level the playing field a little bit, because if people can get, that's how apparently a lot of people make a lot of money. When I downloaded the Durian, someone in my stream said, "Mors, now you know how I made 50x the last three leagues using a program like this." So I say, okay, I guess that makes a lot of sense to me. So that's sort of, it's interesting to me hearing sort of talk about it, because I'm heavily on the side of automation and adding auction house stuff, like, which a lot of people are not in favor of, and I totally respect that and I totally understand that. Even there's a longtime sub of my channel is you know, almost so the vitriol about the auction house, and I think it would work at Peewee, but that's my opinion.
This is an interesting show dynamic we have here then, because it sounds like Waba is kind of a proponent for the old school Wild West of bartering, whereas you're much more towards the auction house side of things, and I'm kind of lingering somewhere in the middle. Typical ZiggyD.
Yeah. And that's, but you know, that again, that comes from me, you know, only really playing Path of Exile, and you guys have played a lot of other games. Recently, Mors was playing Diablo 3, and you played a ton of other games, so I'm sure you see other systems that work well. Right, and they may have their problems too, but like, I'm sure there's something that we could do about it, or some just an idea. And I'm sure, you know, they're working on it, and they're saying they're putting effort into it. I believe that they are. I don't think anybody is putting it past them. But you know, I just find myself wondering, like, what can actually be done with the barter system outside of just throwing in an auction house?
Well, you know, the interesting thing to me is someone who's played. So I've been playing since. Like 2011, something crazy like that. The barter system works, is fantastic. I love it, but it seems like the game's grown too large, almost on, I guess, like horizontally, or, you know, some buzzwords about all this stuff. And the other thing is people don't barter anymore. Like, someone will come to my stream. I tend to alk jewelry a lot. I've always alked, I love alking stuff. And I'll price something at 25 chaos. And I'm hoping that someone comes to me and says, "Hey, what about 15 chaos and 5 alks for it?" And I'd be like, "That's great, perfect." But I mean, I don't want to list it at 15 alks, because then someone might be like, "What about 8 alks?"
And right,
you know. But people seem it's sort of been a weird dynamic. It's been a shift over the last year where people don't barter. It's a barter system, and then they don't barter, or bargain.
Well, whatever you want to call it. And on top of that, even with an auction house, people just set buyouts.
Right.
There's not, it's, you say auction house, so people refer to auction house, but more often than not, in, you know, MMOs and RPGs, when someone puts an item in an auction house, they list a buyout and people buy it out. That's not true.
Even in Diablo 3, like, auction house days, there was very little actual auctioning happening. Most of it was through buyouts, like flipping buyouts or searching buyouts and things like that. There was certainly like a bit of a meta for people auctioning certain things and trying to play the auctions and snipe auctions and things like that, get those last second bids in. But even then, like, the vast majority of them were actually buyouts for sure.
Right. And then, you know, another thing that comes up a lot is just, you know, people are like, "Oh, well, I messaged this person and they're offline, or they're AFK. And that's like probably one of the biggest gripes that people have, right? And what's funny about that is you kind of hit on this a little bit more, but so for me, when I played Diablo 2, when this whole thing got started for me enjoying the barter system, I played on regional servers. And Path of Exile is a game where someone who is playing from Southeast Asia could play with somebody in UK. You can message that person. And that, I think, that creates another layer that people aren't necessarily used to for the barter system, because you're going to have people that leave their clients on. I have no clue why GGG just doesn't make an auto 45-minute logout thing, because I feel like that would cut a lot of those complaints and issues down substantially. And that's something that I don't feel like, you know, people really understand, that such a worldwide game, and we don't have regional servers, that's going to make trading a little bit more difficult, because you don't know where the person's from.
What time zone it is for them and so on, yeah.
Yeah, and the tough part is, like, if I want to trade Ziggy, right, where our hours are not opposite, but definitely it would be tough for us to meet, right? Ziggy, I'm sure you run into it with America.
Yeah, for sure. If I get on a certain time of day, I can expect to find nothing. Like if I want to jump on in the evening and do a little bit of trading, there's basically going to be no one online. I searched for like a helmet with like chaos resist the other day, just that simple, like an energy shield chaos resist helmet. And offline was like hundreds of trades. Online, none. Nothing. Literally zero people with chaos resist AS helmets. I was like, what? What is going on? Did I do this? Did I do the search wrong? What's going on? But no, just no one was online. You mentioned as one of the biggest problems, Boba, of being people being offline when you message them. And I agree. And that's probably the major reason why I'm kind of in the middle at the moment. I don't really want an auction house, despite liking auction houses. I think they're interesting. And I also like the current trade in the game. But the reason why I'm kind of like lingering in the middle is because I want to see what trade will be like when you're messaging people and they're always online when you message them, like when that system is extremely reliable. And GGG has said that very soon they're going to be giving improved API support for places like PoE Trade to make sure that those things are updated very quickly, if not instantly, so that the moment someone logs offline, their trade things is removed from their site. I don't know how possible that's going to be because of, you know, the obvious limitations of like servers, people running PoE Trade. You know, this guy's pretty much doing this out of pocket, I'm pretty sure. So, which is a little scary.
Right. Yeah, definitely.
Considering we're so reliant on it. But if, like, I think that if you are always messaging people and they're always online, you're always finding those items online, then that's going to be, I think, just such a big leap forwards for where we're at right now that I'm very interested to see how good trade is just with that one improvement, let alone other improvements like off cross-instance trading or potential improvements in the future, like trading with people who are actually offline via browsers and things like that.
Right.
Well, can I have a thought experiment then real quick? Because I've
now. Exciting. No.
Okay. No. Yes. Okay. So if PoE Trade doesn't exist, now the part that we have to agree upon, since it's a thought experiment, is no one has taken the place of PoE Trade, so it just doesn't exist. Do you think PoE is as successful a game without that? Like I'm saying, I realize option two is really someone else makes the same system roughly and it works close. I'm just saying, let's say it doesn't exist. Where is PoE at that point?
We did get a little bit of a experiment with that recently, actually. PoE Trade went down for a couple of days. Yeah, and it was like the Wild West again, man. People were freaking out.
Yeah.
Like so. Getting back into trade chat to try and buy like really basic items and stuff like that. It was a pretty interesting experience, and it made me realize how kind of like fragile the current setup is. That's just probably one of the main issues with it, really. Is that this guy, that GGG haven't hired this guy. They don't have him on the internal team.
right.
But in addressing your original question, though, that do I think PoE would be as successful? No, I don't think it would be as successful. I think on the majority, the average player requires more efficient trade. Even like towards the end of an auction house, I think the average player that comes to PoE, and you know, if we're talking about getting as many numbers into PoE as possible, as many people enjoying the game as possible, then we're like talking towards the end of auction houses. Now, I'm not necessarily saying that's the correct direction for PoE, though, because PoE's not really built itself on being a game that gets everybody into the game, right? It's funny, though, because we have Diablo 3 going in the opposite direction, right, where it started with an auction house and was not very friendly to everyone, and then it moved away from that, so it's weird to see this kind of like crossover, and that's another thing that supports my idea that there's somewhere in between that is the correct spot for Path of Exile to be.
Is there even an auction house in Diablo 3 anymore? Like, I don't know.
There's no trade in Diablo 3 anymore. They went the complete opposite direction. They removed the auction house because of the I feel like the removal of the auction house in Diablo 3 wasn't just the decision of them saying that the auction house is wrong for Diablo 3. I think it was them saying we want to try a completely new loot system at the same time as saying that we need a rebranding for this game, essentially. We need to do something very drastic that everyone's asking for, even if it's not exactly what we want to do, to be able to get people back in and try this game again now that we've made some significant changes. So, there's literally no trading in Diablo 3 right now. You can trade, like, some rare items, but there's never a point for it because you basically only use legendaries in that game. So it's entirely self-found with a loot system that's balanced around you finding and crafting your own loot.
Well, and it's so interesting you bring that up, Ziggy, because I'd never heard of this, but there's something called Hotelling's Law, which says that products in a marketplace over time make sense for them to come closer and closer together in terms of, you know, if they start disparate, they should be trending towards each other. And I'll be honest, I really do see that, especially with PoE more than, well, D3, because it was so disappointing to so many people. So they've done all these things and I hate crediting PoE for stuff because maybe I don't know what comes from Torchlight or something. I don't really care, but I saw it in PoE, and so D3 is now starting to do whatever it is, map system or, you know, all this other stuff, trying to take that, these elements that really work with PoE, attract a more hardcore audience. At least that's their hope. But then PoE is just a little bit moving towards D3, right? They fixed desync, which was a huge problem for people. I think that the game is honestly faster and more arcadey. And I don't want to use that word lightly. You know, it's not like D3. D3, it feels very, you know, brah, you blow the barrels up and the monsters go flying and the ragdoll and everything. But like, PoE is definitely faster paced than it was even a year ago. So I think you see that happening right now. So Will, does that mean that we can get some of the stuff that D3 was trying? Because I think just because D3 failed spectacularly at something like an auction house doesn't mean that we couldn't try something. That's all.
Yeah, that's like people like visibly like start vomiting when you mention the idea of an auction house, because they like it didn't work for Diablo 3, so it can't ever possibly work. But I'm really glad that Blizzard did try to do it. It didn't work for the way they had designed their game. But I do think an auction house like system is very interesting in and of itself. And I do think it could work in a game. I just think that that's a very important point to make, I think, is that just because it didn't work for Diablo 3 doesn't mean it could work for other games. Again, I'm not like saying that necessarily it's the right choice for PoE, but we could be heading a little more in that direction, and it could be right for PoE to head more in that direction.
Right. Well, but Blizzard's clear failure was not having someone like Chris at the helm, and I don't say, or really Carl too, you know, people who really get the ARPG experience, because like, you're just thinking about it, Inferno in Diablo, you needed the gear from the end of the act to beat the first part of the act. Yes. So how are you going to get, you know what I mean? There was terrible.
That's, yeah. Just,
you know, and PoE does such a better job at that. And I think that the gear is so much more interesting. I mean, D3's gotten a lot better than it was for sure. But I mean, PoE, you know, in terms of gems and links and all this stuff, this is coming from someone, I spent 2,100 fusings this league on a chest, didn't get a 6-link, I would not change anything, because that's part of what makes it sort of like a hardcore experience. That's why I don't want to throw out everything. I mean, I mean, Chris seems very adamant about it, so I think we're not going to ever get it, but I'd like to take some of this. Like, what if it was just, like you were saying, someone wants to trade with me, and on my phone, I can click yes trade. They can touch the item somehow, and I can say okay, and they put the currency some, you know what I mean? Like something where I don't have to be here at my computer to trade. That's what I want. Maybe not automated, but something through a message on the website. I don't know.
Well, while go ahead. Oh, I was about to say, while I am against the general idea of auction houses, the idea of having some form of asynchronous trading, which I guess with everything being a bio would essentially just kind of be an auction house, it would be cool to, you know, be away from Path of Exile and to come back and find 50 chaos in a mailbox of some sort or somewhere for me to pick up. Because I'm like, oh, cool, I sold this stuff. Because I definitely know I miss out on a lot of trades for a huge number of reasons. But I don't. It's just rough. And
I do like making money while I'm sleeping.
Yes, yes. Yeah, it's the best. But, you know, that's... With the way the currency is rolled into like our whole crafting materials, which is brilliant. This is probably the best thing Path of Exile did, in my opinion. Just like the way they took their currency, and it is the crafting system, and that's absolutely brilliant, because that makes people want those orbs, so you could do whatever you want with the loot. So I don't know. I'm at a loss.
So that's an interesting kind of point on trading as well, as the currency system, because the more and more efficient trading becomes, and we've already seen this trend over time, the less attractive crafting your items becomes as a result. And it's to the point now where for me to use even oftentimes things like Kale Swords these days is I'm stupid giving myself the artificial restriction of playing self-found. That's the only time I'm using a lot of the actual crafting in the game. And that's because trade is just so much more efficient. Like, I could spend... Oftentimes, I could try an Alcon item, but I'm most likely going to have better results spending that Alcon PoE trade. That same Alcon. Like, one low-tier crafting item is going to be better spent on a trading system. And that's because the current system is fairly efficient, even though it's annoying. It's annoying in a lot of ways, but it is still fairly efficient. So to become even more efficient is going to mean that not only is crafting currency going to be less impactful in the game, and we're going to lose potentially, there is the potential of losing one of those things that is unique about Path of Exile, but on top of that, drops become less exciting too.
Right.
The more efficient trade becomes.
Well, and it's interesting you bring up the crafting, because I felt, you know, that was really one of the main reasons people showed up to my stream, is I did some crazy crafting of various things, you know, wrecking ball and all this stuff. I don't do that anymore, because it's just here. I mean, it's the ratio of currency to what you can get to. Well, I mean, this is where I start to sound like a negative Nancy, which I sort of hate. But like Masters and Divination cards, to me, have hurt, like I think they hurt. I don't want to be like, I don't want to say to be too strong about it, but I think them in the stew of the trade stew is what causes these problems. Like, for instance, I like crafting glorious plates. You have to be like going against the stream. You have to be that salmon going against the stream to craft a glorious plate, because you can get an astral plate for like 3x, a 6-link astral plate for 3x from the Celestial Justicar, or even cheaper. And I like that. That to me really threw a lot of stuff out of whack in the stream. I don't know. And I mean, that's where the efficiency comes in. That's where, if they did something like what I want, like an auction house, would that be really bad? And that's very, I'm very nervous about something like that, where it becomes, it's almost trivial. You get a 6-link for an X, which can just drop, you know, I don't know, one drops every 50, 100 hours playing PvE on average, whatever the number is. So that, I don't think a 6-link should be that common. I've never seen one drop in my 10,000 hours of PoE, so...
I don't think I've actually had one drop either. I got one from a lockbox.
It's funny you guys say that, because in the past month, I've had 3 drop.
Okay.
I've had 3 6 links drop.
Right. Damn.
Yeah, a sword and 2 armor pieces. So, yeah, and then I bought a 6 link glorious plate for 2.5 exalts at the beginning of this league.
Yeah.
So, yeah, they are more common, and...
But they're not in demand, because you could get the astral for the divination card just really skewed the market. So,
and now we have 2 divination cards.
Oh, that's right. What is it called? The butler or something?
This any 6 link based chest. Yeah. Isn't the chains that bond or something?
No, there's that too. I think there's 3 of them then.
Oh, is there 3?
Yeah. Chains that bind. And then there's some, I'll have to Google it while you guys talk, but yeah, I sold one and I don't remember the name now. Anyway.
Well, so, like, all right. So, another action RPG is like, so Devillion. I have little experience with that, but was there anything in Devillion that kind of seemed like it could work well in this setting?
Devillion, although it has a lot of action RPG elements, has very true MMO gear. So it has an MMO auction house, typically what you see that, and because the gear is for the most part the same, it's not too comparable. We don't have actually too many things to compare to, because there is not many games with auction houses that have what action RPG loot has. Action RPG loot is very different to MMO loot for most games, in that you have this like complete stat randomization where you can have any one of hundreds of stats, you know, in each slot on the gear, rather than it being like a set item. Like the most set item that we have for Path of Exile is just the base item, which is usually just like just armor or just base energy shield or just base physical damage and attack speed. But yeah, Devillion had much more MMO style loot, so pretty hard to make a direct comparison there, I think.
I've never played Devillion, so I couldn't even begin to talk about it.
And see, like, knowing where D3 is with what you're saying, with there's no trade in Diablo 3, and when you were talking about Hotelling's Law, I'm like, wow, that's interesting. But how could Path of Exile eventually do that, or, you know, get close to that?
I guess one of the interesting points about, or important points about Diablo 3's auction house failing is that they also have a very different gear system to us. The gear is, although it is action RPG gear, it is much more streamlined than Path of Exile's gear. Like, you have very much set things that you want to get on every gear piece for every build. And obviously we have, like, life and resists and things like that. And attack speed is going to be good for a lot of attack builds and things like that. But there's a much, much, much more diverse set of stats that is interesting or attractive to builds. Now that I say that, though, I wonder that if we use a diverse range of stats because trade's inefficient. I just kind of had that realization myself that if trade was really efficient, would we all just be using life, armor, tri-res? Like, would we just all be using the perfect stats for our build on each item piece because it would be much easier to find those? Like, maybe right now I only use, like, you know, one of those kind of, like, not quite as good but still interesting for my build stats because it's not easy to get the perfect item. Interesting. Musing aloud.
Yeah.
Well, and that's, hasn't that sort of, that's been Chris's central thesis almost, or the GGG dev team central thesis, that they need those things in order to make the experience last the appropriate amount of time. Like, that's why we have garbage, life regen, thorns, all this crap, right? And they add every time they extend the tiers, or, you know, they would be bad. I would say make a new tier one, but the tier 16 life, whatever the top life is, they want to add accuracy and light radius so that we all have much more of a chance to get a garbage stat, and then the quest continues and keeps going. And I can definitely appreciate that, because that, to me, that's kind of ties into the masters, why I don't like masters, because I think it makes it so much easier for the gear acquisition process to end.
It gets you to the point of good enough gear quicker, for sure. Yeah. Like, you can just get that bit of extra fire resist you need without changing around several items. I feel like I know you're pretty unhappy with masters in general. I think that their positives overall outweigh their negatives, but I do agree that they do have that impact of shortening that time for the average player to get good enough gear for them, because there is the perfect gear, but most players don't go for the perfect gear. Most players go for the good enough gear so that they can do mid to higher tier maps. And you can definitely do that with just the one Chaos Mastercrafted item these days.
Right. And I'm clearly, I've said this before, I am so in the minority in hating masters. They're never going to go away. Right. I'm grandpa on the lawn yelling to slow down or whatever about that. I hate them, but for me, I still think we can rein in some of the things they do. Like, for instance, I think that the life on rings is too high, for up 34 to 44. I think it should be more like 20 to 30. And I definitely think the life on helm, gloves, boots is way, way too, like 64. It only goes to 89, I think, on gloves and boots. Or no, sorry. Do boots go to 99? So it's definitely gloves for sure. If you find super crazy gloves, they don't have life, you just master life on, yes, for a hardcore player or end game player, that 15 life is going to, sorry, 25 life is going to, you need that. It's going to save you at some point. And I appreciate all that stuff, but in the grand scheme of things, it's easy, like you're saying, you reach that point of, well, it's good enough for now. The only way I would replace this is if it had attack speed and mana leech and then 80 life. And how often you find a 3x item when you're, you know, whatever the expensive. So it's just, to me, I feel like I just wish the power was a little less, so there was still a need for the mid tier, because I used to make a lot of money selling garbage rares that would fill that role, and I didn't sell them. It's not like I was selling them for 1x. I'd sell them for 3 chaos, 2 chaos, and I think that's great. That's a good business, and there were other people doing that. There's no real market kind of for that anymore, because for me at least, some of the 5 chaos items you used to sell, 5 to 10 chaos, are now only worth 2 to 3, because they were good only because they had 79 life and some decent stuff, and now you can't. I don't know.
I play a mixture of hardcore and softcore. There's still a little bit of a market for stuff like that in hardcore, but in softcore, that's nothing. Like, you just can't sell anything like that in softcore at all. So I was disappointed in my last softcore league that trading to me felt a lot less interesting this time around. Like, there was just a lot less interesting lower tier items selling. So I've definitely been seeing that trend over time. I think I agree with you about the point of nerfing master, like, amounts to make them that like this is not quite good enough tier. Whereas at the moment, right. this is more than good enough. That's where masters are at the moment. But I think I would like to see what a Path of Exile would look like with masters being like, this is not quite good enough, but it's going to tide me over until I find or buy or craft something better with the actual crafting currency and such.
I agree on helms and on boots. Like sometimes I see some of these like really good, you know, pieces of gear with crafted life on it. I'm like, holy shit, that's a lot of life. Like that thing's good. You wouldn't do that. And when you bring that up, it kind of brings up the idea that the amount of time that you have to invest to get gear that's good enough, and there's a huge gap in between that amount of time and the time to get that perfect gear. So why would someone do that? Like, why would someone actually go after that, the perfect gear when the good enough stuff is actually amazing? Like, it's perfectly fine. You know, rings, I think rings are a little low, but helms and boots and gloves are definitely really high.
Yeah. Well, and it's definitely, it's interesting because we're talking, it's like they want you to, on the path of least resistance, where it's a, you know, it's a slow slope. They don't want you to plummet off the cliff, which is what D3 in both ways was, where it's like it's self-found and everyone just gets everything, and they've kind of pulled back, it seems like, a little bit from that. Or there was the other way where you can't acquire anything and the auction house is just terrible. And so it's interesting. So it's very fascinating to me that this is not a binary one or zero answer to any of this. And then they could do something that's right, but then the economy or the game reacts, you know, like mathematically or however, that what they did was the exact right thing to do, but then things blow up because they don't foresee X happening or whatever it is.
That's why I think GGG is being super cautious about this. Like, I've been kind of watching how they've been approaching this over time, and they're like doing very tiny changes over time, and a lot of the community is calling for a very dramatic change. And I'm very guilty of this. Last expansion, I was saying, GGG, we need a trade system overhaul. This, and I'm like, now I'm thinking, whoa, okay, GGG, I understand why you didn't listen to me, because making a very dramatic change all at once could be brutal for the game. It could be entirely destructive. Like, it would be very hard to pull back from something that just completely destroyed things. Thankfully, we have this kind of three-month season thing where maybe you could recover from a really dramatic change, but it's I think it makes a lot more sense to be taking this kind of like slower series of changes to see how each one pans out. Like, even if it's once every 3 months, it's not maybe the speed of improvements that a lot of people want to see, but I do think it maybe is the better choice for the game. Like, for this next expansion, we're getting the trade API improvements and cross-instance trading. So they're going to see how the trade API improvements and cross-instance trading work out. One's a convenience feature. I can't imagine having too much of an impact on, like, the item hunt or anything. But still, it's maybe just that extra convenience gets more people trading, and it does have a big impact. It's hard to actually tell the level of impact even a minor change could have.
Well, I find myself wondering a lot how much, or the frustration that players experience, how much of that is from a large portion of the community just not wanting to deal with it? And then how much of it is just like, you know, as the game slows down, as leagues, you know, go through their phases of, you know, everyone's playing it right now, but a month afterwards, you know, fewer people are playing. Like, where does that frustration lie? Because a lot of people, you know, especially a lot of players who want to do just self-found, you know, they just don't want to. It's like you don't want to participate in the system that exists. And that's kind of a problem.
I think I have to say at this point that I really like trading in PoE right now. It's actually very enjoyable when you do get stuck into it. And there is a lot of people who are unwilling to even try it because of some of the perceived difficulties with it, the way most people talk about it. And even myself, I rage against some of the frustrations, like, here's the fifth person I've messaged that's offline. That certainly does happen. But on the whole, the trading experience in PoE is actually really enjoyable. I do have a very good time with it in its current iteration. So that's another reason why I'm kind of like drawn in two directions on this, because I am worried about losing some of what we have now, that kind of enjoyable trade experience.
It could be rewarding too. Especially, you know, when you have an item that you do haggle down, or someone haggles with you. And a lot of times when I get someone who messaged me for a trade, they're like, oh, price on that. And I give them a price, and then they don't even message me back. And, I'll be streaming when this happens, and I say, and I'll say to my stream, I just want this person to message me back. Like that's it. I just want them to engage me. And I don't want to be like, oh, yeah, okay, 15C for that ring. Oh, well, you haven't messaged me back in 2 or 3 minutes, so you know what? I'll do 9C. A lot of people just, they take that first step, but then they don't go any further. And that's a little troubling to me, because we have a system that could work if people just wanted to do it. So how do we get players to want to do it?
I think there's some initial hurdles that stop people from trading in the first place. Just the fact that they have to go to a third-party site, install acquisition, and then set it up, even though it's super easy. Like, literally, it takes a couple minutes to do, even for an unacquainted player with the software to figure it out. Very easy to do, and there's tons of good guides for it and things like that. But because it's that initial little hurdle, and there is that perception that this is a really complex thing because it doesn't look very friendly to do, right? When you look at someone using acquisition on stream or something, you're like, that's what you have to do to trade in this game? Oh my god. It's like, I have to run Excel spreadsheets and stuff? Like, I don't have a degree in trading in Path of Exile. How am I supposed to do this? But it is actually very simple once you just get over that initial hurdle. But that initial hurdle is, I think, too much for most players, and there are still people I talk to today that say, I only really like jump on trade chat every now and then because I can't be bothered going through the rest of the process, or I just play self-found because, and I don't enjoy self-found, but I just play it because I can't see myself getting past that initial hurdle. So I think I think a big part of the issue is that it certainly gets worse as the league progresses, because early on in the league, there's just a larger pool of people to pull from. So even if like 40% of people just don't want to interact with trade at all, there's still that 60% is larger amount, so it's not as bad. But you do notice it much more in the later leagues, in later sections of the league, that it does get more and more painful, because there are not a bunch of people who don't want to interact in the trading system properly. Even if they do kind of take that step to list up their items, they don't stick with it. They don't stick with the process.
Well, isn't that a really, it's interesting hearing you guys talk about it, because it strikes me it's just like what PoE's problem is. And maybe it's a strength, maybe it's a weakness. It's the same thing where someone starts playing PoE, the skill tree makes their head explode, and they're like, okay, whatever, let me just go try to kill some monsters. And they go to kill Hellrake, and Hellrake just bends them over and they're dead. And they're just like, all right, I don't know what's going on. So it's really interesting, because it's how do we bridge, or how do we get over that gap, so that people realize that you need to put in 2-3 hours, and then you'll get, if you like ARPGs, you'll really enjoy it. It's like, how do we, that's actually one of the things I've always been sort of confused about GDG, because as a longtime racer who's killed Brutus thousands of times at this point, the fact that I could still die to Brutus in normal or Hellrake, and I understand I'm doing something risky because it's a race and everything, but that's really amazing that the game's like that, right? I think that's one of the core strengths of the game. But then on the other hand, that's also going to be something where there could be someone who would love PoE, love it, would give them $1,000, give me a unique and all this stuff, but because they don't get past that 5-hour thing, they're not going to invest. And I think it's just like what you said, maybe they love trading, because I've always loved trading in PoE. It's actually, the content, when I started playing, the content was kind of crap. The content's so much better than it ever was, four years ago. The trading was always fun, though. So there was all these things you could do. You could match the names, get the alks, alk things. You could then bust it all up into alts and craft those. I mean, it's like, the circular, like you were saying, Wabacha, with the currency being the thing you craft with and then trade with, there was such a good feeling doing that stuff. But if you can't get over that investment, right, even if it's just psychological, I feel so sad. Like friends like my dad, I don't think my dad would play PoE, because it would just be too much investment. He'd be like, well, I spent all this time learning Falcon 4 flight game, and I've got my flight stick, so that's what I put my time into. I don't want to invest, even though he would love PoE. He just won't get past that investment. So how do we do that? That would be my, how do we get past that? How do we get them? That's why I'm hoping the API changes alleviate some of those things. So
I have a box of magic cards here. I got sent like a massive box just full of magic cards. I have all of these here. And that's the exact reason why I don't unbox these and play this game, because I have this perception that the investment required for me to get to the point of enjoyment with this game is too high. And I understand that Magic is a very enjoyable game, and I already have the cards, but right. there is that like perception of a massive amount of investment that I have to overcome first to get into it. There are certain things that will kind of weed out the players who won't enjoy the game long term, and I don't think that's too much of a problem, like being killed by Harrow Rake and Brutus and stuff like that. Those are fine. There are things that weed out players that could enjoy the game, and that is a problem. I think trade might be one of those, and I certainly think things like desync and like the early game being a little too slow and like not having many skills available to your early game and stuff like that, those were things which GGG has been improving over time that weeded out players that would actually enjoy the game long term. There was just kind of this initial point of confusion, like what's this game's deal, because it wasn't there. And I think trade might be one of those, because trading in Path of Exile is very good, but it is hard to get over that initial hurdle, and that is weeding out a lot of players that might actually enjoy trading. Because I, you know, through my various guides and things like that I make for trading, people will come to me regularly and say, "Hey, I finally installed Acquisition. I followed your guide for trading. Whatever, I did this thing, and I was like, I made 25 chaos today in a couple hours, and I'm like, I'm having a great time. I'm loving trading now. I'm like getting super into it, and they're enjoying the game on the whole a lot more. So there are a lot of people who are being weeded out from enjoying the trading system that would actually enjoy it right now.
Right. And, oh, go ahead, Mors.
No, go ahead. Go
well,
ahead.
What I was about to say is, and really, in all honesty, who's to blame players for not wanting to jump into a game, learn its mechanics, and then have an easier time playing Path of Exile? Who's to blame them? Because, you know, what's normal for people who've been playing it for a while, or people who are really into it, because the people who are really into action RPGs and into Path of Exile, they're playing it. Like, if we want to get those new players, it should be a little bit more appealing. And again, who's to blame them for not wanting to have to go to a third-party website, have to install a third-party program, contact people? You know, there's so many steps for failure, or there's so many steps that a player has to take to do it as efficiently as possible. And I don't blame them for that. Even though I don't think anything of it, I don't blame them for it.
I'll throw out my own thought experimental question for you guys is do you think that if GGG were to incorporate the features of Acquisition and PoE trade in game and in browser, in their entirety, exactly as they are right now, I feel like maybe Waba, you can answer this question because of your position on it, but I feel like that is very close to being an auction house, right? If you bring those two things together and put them in the game, is that basically an auction house, at least in the sense that auction houses are typically used, like in Diablo, where you're not actually auctioning much, you're mostly buying things? Like, and then if you have especially like offline trading, asynchronous trading, or cross-instance trading and things like that, is that basically an auction house? And do you think that would, like Mors was talking about earlier, help level the playing field? Because at the moment, we have access to these features. They're just over a hurdle. You have to kind of climb a steep, shitty-looking hill covered with like rocks that are rolling down and shit before you get to that point.
Yeah, I think that would be. Because, I mean, on top of that, you know, you get a player, you get someone who, you know, they see right now with the SimC coming out, we were having all this press on like GameSpot. So we have a person who hasn't played an action RPG in a long time. Say they haven't played one since Diablo 2 for whatever reason, right? And they see Path of Exile. When they get into the game and they see a lot of things, if there was a tool for them to list their tabs, you know, the same way you do an Acquisition, they would immediately be like, "Oh, how do I use this?" But since they don't ever see that tool, they're not aware of how easy it could be.
There is nothing in the game that points to how you trade in Path of Exile.
Exactly.
Like, you get a lot of new people joining and be like, they open trade chat because that's the only thing they see that says trade in game.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and so...
Like, they're like, this is how we're supposed to trade?
Yeah, and while that might essentially just be an auction house, or what we know as an auction house, that would work. Just having these tools in the game would work.
Obviously. So that's my question then. Do we not already have an auction house in PoE? It's just for the elite who have taken the effort to learn how to use it. Like,
It's just out of client. It's just in a browser and in a third-party program.
I mean, you could get caught up on semantics and say, well, it's not technically an auction house and yada yada, but it's the same thing. Diablo 3's auction house was barely an auction house because most people were just doing buyouts. Most people were just listing their item. I want 50,000 gold for this, or I want 20 chaos for this, and then someone clicks the buy button and it's automatically shifted across. Like, maybe the current system, if implemented directly into the game, would still have players like meet each other in an instance or open a trade window with each other and communicate in some fashion. But if ZiggyD does implement the other features they're looking to implement of asynchronous trading, then it is essentially going to be the exact same thing as an auction house. So I feel like we're almost already there. It's just there's just no way to find it for a lot of players.
In fact, I think that if we had something like that, if we actually did have this in the game, there would be more bidding. There would be actual auctioning in Path of Exile because of the way our currency works. I mean, so you might be like, okay, like, oh yeah, I'll raise this up to 35 and eventually just get to the buyout. But we have tons of items that are like that. I mean, that's, I feel like there's a lot more room for an auction house to work well in Path of Exile. It's just hard.
Well, you know, the funny part to me is how it's sort of a stigma around auction house. Like, yeah. I want to call it banana. And then everyone likes bananas or apples or something. And then it'll be great. And I mean, I know that's...
I know. When we call it asynchronous trade system overhaul, people are like, yeah, bring that on.
Yeah.
I'm like, but it's going to be exactly the same as the auction house. I'm like, no, did you say auction house?
You don't get it.
And it's just because of Diablo 3's launch was shitty that people associate auction house with being bad. Even though that was... Maybe not. I don't know if the auction house was actually the problem. I think it was actually the loot system in Diablo 3 that was the problem.
Yes, thank you, God. I mean, that's what drives me so crazy. The problem is the fundamental architecture upon which the game is based. ARPGs are gear-based games, so if the gear sucks because it was designed by an idiot, yes, the whole thing's gonna suck. PoE is so much better designed. That's why I hate when we're just like, no, we can't have this. When we have it right now, and all I want to do is improve quality of life for people, because that's, to me, like, that's the key. Lately, at least, that's the key, because PoE has been winning for the, I would say, okay, so do they do everything right all the time? No, no one does. I don't. Nobody does. But their trend is clearly upward. And right? we see more and more people are watching on Twitch, more and more people are playing. That's what I think. And it's
and
all
I think
about,
that's a good thing for the game overall as well. Like, there's a debate about whether more and more people is a good thing for PoE, whether it loses its way. And there are always going to be some people who are put out by certain changes, like you for Masters, for example.
Right. Yeah. No.
But I think overall it's a good thing, though.
Yeah, I hope they continue with it. And it just it's definitely one of those things where it's funny that people were calling for the trading thing. And I still remember when I saw you, because I actually think you said, well, I don't know if it was the first time you said it, but it was in State of Exile or the podcast where you'd said that you think trading is the number one thing, which surprised me because I was like, that sounds like something I would say, not necessarily Ziggy would say so strongly. And I think the desync thing was clearly the right fix. And it's interesting. It's interesting.
I agree with that now.
Okay. And I 100% agree. I was, it's funny. I don't care about the desync fix because I was so, to me, it was a body 300 yards down the river. I was never going to think about it again. I never thought they would fix desync. So I was just going to have to live with this.
In that state.
Right. It's, you know. So I'm thrilled. I think they did things right, and I hope that we get that small change that they say they're doing. Because to me, it's weird. It's one of those things where it's not even that they need to do something. I sometimes feel like I think it's just even psychological, just for people to see something was done, even if it's a small thing that only cost one tenth of a Jonathan unit, as I would call it. You know, whatever. Right? Not a. We don't need a total Jonathan unit. We need one tenth of his unit for the month. To a lot of time to, you know, make this thing. And then, okay, people feel better because something got done and more stuff's happening.
I think we could all benefit from a bit of a touch by one-tenth of Jonathan's unit.
Yeah. It's, you know.
He does work with it. He does God's work with it.
Right, exactly.
Yeah. Well, you know, on that, I feel like we do kind of get that with trade right now. Oh, we do get these little things. Well, at least they said that they're working on little things. You know, they're saying they're improving the API for, you know, third-party developers and saying that. But that doesn't seem like it's enough for a lot of people. And it's just like, desync was huge, right? That was a huge quality of life improvement for Path of Exile. And I had people that I knew that didn't play Path of Exile specifically because of desync. So I tell them, hey, desync's gone. Guess what? They're still, you know, then they want to try it. But trade is now like the second thing, and there are still the people who enjoy it. You know, there's still the people who think there's nothing wrong with it. And it's just like it comes down to like a player's personal preference. And is it just because of all the other games that we've had in the past? I mean, where was the first big auction house? My first big experience with it was in World of Warcraft. That was my first experience with auction house, mailboxes, and all that stuff seems really cool, but it just seems, it to me initially, although we do essentially already have it, seems a little out of place.
Isn't that just the vagaries of the human condition that we're kind of dicks and right. We always want something? Like, desync was fixed. Great, man. That was last month, even though that was a huge deal. You know, we're like, I want this next thing. I always want to make sure I like think positive thoughts. Even if I might rant about it for a little bit, I want to think positive thoughts because there's good things are happening. That said, I definitely am nervous about if they did something with an auction house or something like that, is just the fact that they did it because there just seems to be this very vitriolic element in the community. Will that affect other people who were sort of on the fence? Is it almost not worth it doing it just because there's enough of a backlash?
Because hear that they put an auction house in PoE and they just like, oh, but that sounds terrible because of Diablo 3.
Right. Yeah. Right. Yeah. So like, I'm definitely cognizant of that. And I hope that, this is where I wish GGG shared a little more, which of course people would say, wait, GGG shares a lot of stuff all the time. I think that they're not as stupid as Blizzard, but Blizzard still shares a lot of stuff. Like if you go and look at, it just is so much longer between when you get a blue post, right? Chris is every day, which is what makes him really cool and why me personally, why I invested money in the game because of someone like Chris. But they still keep stuff back, and I do think partially because if they shared what they were thinking or doing, there'd be people who would yell at them, like, why are you doing this? But I feel
you definitely shouldn't tell people everything you're doing. I think right. As much as I love GGG's communication, if they told people everything that they were planning on doing with trade and that, then there is the potential that before people even have a chance to even see how it's implemented, they have a backlash towards it, and that spoils it, it poisons the well before they even draw water from it, essentially.
Isn't that just under promise, over deliver?
Well, yeah. That's what they did with desync, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah. You know?
Definitely. We're improving it. It's like out of nowhere, we're finally at the point where we can tell you that we're actually going to fix desync. It was like, what? We didn't even know you were even trying. Right. Yeah.
Which then, and things like that makes me very hopeful for it. But then that goes back to, like, have we lost too many players to something like trade? Or are people so, you know, caught up on their frustrations with it now that they're not even going to look past it? That
every major expansion and every major marketing push for the game is one step closer to this imaginary too late point for trade improvements. Yes. Like, I was worried about that with the last expansion, but the desync fixes and that were more than enough, I think, so that... But now I'm worried with this next expansion, like there's a big marketing push and this is going to be a big influx of new players, you know, tapping that imaginary maximum amount of potential Path of Exile players. And you know, if trade isn't heavily improved by that point, then it is I'm a bit worried that it'll be too late beyond then.
And it's interesting because I actually think, I've been sort of reflecting on this, I think that people don't quit PoE in the sense of trading's nothing's happening, so I'm done with PoE. They're done with the league or the challenge league earlier than they were before, is what it seems like a little bit to me. Because I went and played D3 and I came back and I was like, oh, nobody's trading anymore. You know, I used to get 10, 15 whispers a day and I was down to one or two, and then trying to buy stuff, nobody was there. And I'd go to their thread and last updated January 24th or something. So that means they're not playing on a daily basis. So I feel like it's an interesting point that you bring up the too late point. I feel like has probably happened a little bit, just in the sense of people move their quit date up a little sooner in the league. And unfortunately, since PoE is a great pyramid scheme, right? If I want to do Uber at Ziri, I need 100 vassals out there farming the things to let me do that.
Yeah.
So when they revolt and kill each other or leave, I can't be a king of nothing, right? So then you can't participate.
King's your crown, king nothing.
Yeah. So yeah. It's so crazy to me because I had so much fun playing Talisman. I know it's not what we're talking about, but I had a lot of fun this league. But I felt like the pain of trying to either organize the talismans thing, because that's what I always find. Whenever there's something where trading is involved as a core concept in the league, that's where it seems to, the league gets hurt. Like Tempests, well, okay, with trading and Tempests and Warbands being of the same vein, you need others to facilitate your enjoyment, right? Trading, you need to trade with me, I need to find you. Tempest, I need to trust that you tell me that, you know, core maps have of 1,000 items, whatever. I forget what the name of the Tempest were, but
Shining.
Shining, whatever. And then so then people would game the system, right? Because they, oh, I've got 12 Malachi maps to sell, so we're gonna game the website that people are using. You know, someone hosted for free and was not hosted through GGG, which I thought was a mistake. Personally, the GGG didn't have its own tracking, and I think that all ties back to the trading, because they don't have their own, some, you know what I mean? Like, so if the API comes along, I think that will alleviate a lot of these concerns. So it's one of these where I want to see, I'm very excited to see what happens, and I hope they are, this just like you said, under promise, over delivered. They're doing something for API, and there's going to be this one other cool thing that they show us at the same time, and then I'll be happy.
I think it makes a lot of sense that GGG relies, as an indie development team, heavily on third-party software, and that's like been like, more than, like, not even an excuse, it's been like completely reasonable that has been the past. But I do think, I do hope now that the game is growing to the point where they can start to wean themselves off of that reliance in some regards, because way back at the start of the show, you said about like this idea of the level playing field, that there are players who know how to do these things and there are other players who don't. And although basically an auction house already exists in the game, it's just about whether you know or have overcome that hurdle to do that, and there is very much not that level playing field at the moment. And GGG has the potential to do that now, to create a much more level playing field. And I think that would be... I think it is now. I said this. I know I said this last league, so my opinion is...
Here we go!
My opinion is perhaps worth a little less because of it, but I do think it is the number one thing in the game right now. Is improvements to training, is in potentially incorporating these things into the game in some fashion.
I want Jonathan's unit squarely on training.
Yeah. On this subject, I think what's interesting about it, I want to use another word than interesting because we've said that a lot. But anyway, what's interesting about it is that GGG has already shown a willingness to incorporate integration, you know, or seamless user use, because one of the coolest things about Path of Exile when I first started playing it was the website and how you could link your items in a forum post and how that worked. So they have things that does make it like, oh, you know, you could post all this stuff for trading. And then, of course, a third-party developer did come along, and that makes sense that we have someone who does things like that, and that we have this tool that could parse all the information on the forums and whatnot. So they've shown a willingness to do it, and, you know, to what Ziggy's saying, it is true that it makes sense for them to rely on the third party, or not rely on it, but be reliant on that, because that allows them to further other development. But so I have a thought experiment now, okay? And I thought about this while we were chatting. We all generally play challenge leagues, but I don't think we've really talked about this in the terms of a standard player, because I feel like trading in standard, not in hardcore, because I have my own issues with hardcore. Nobody plays hardcore, because hardcore players play challenge leagues. But in standard, now I wish we had a standard player on, because I feel like they might be able to offer something. You know, I just don't know. Like, what if there are no challenge leagues? I know that's drastic. I know that's crazy, right? But
I'm going to string you up for that.
Yeah.
For even suggesting such an idea. Like, I think that there's probably some interesting insights that a standard player could offer, but I think standard players are not the players we're talking about when we're talking about trade improvements. Because let's just say me, right? I'm someone who's played almost 4,000 hours of this game now, by my calculations. And for me, the current trade system is fine. For me, I have no problems with the current trade system other than some minor annoyances, like people are offline when I message them. A few fixes like that, cross-instance trading, would be all I need to fully enjoy trading in this game. But these trade fixes I'm talking about are not for me. They're for what I perceive to be the long-term health of the game, and that's mostly to do with new players, to do with returning players and new people that come to the game. That's what I think. That's who I think trade needs to be improved for, and I think that is not standard players. There's a reason why the default league is the current non-hardcore challenge league. Because I think that's a much, much better experience for the vast majority of new players. There's always going to be a couple of new players that join and want to start in standard, but like, it makes sense that even for their first character, even if they are joining the game for the first time and they're going to be a standard player long-term, for them to start in a challenge league first off and then just take that character standard and continue on it.
So with that said, do you think that when a new player approaches Path of Exile, they see the challenge league, so that's like the biggest draw for them? Like, because I know...
I don't think they know it at that point. I don't think most new players know it at that point. And I think that's why GGG is like, this is the default league selected, so that they go, okay, I'll go with the recommended. Because most people play the recommended difficulty or the recommended mode by the developers. And that's, like, it's very smart that GGG have done that. I'm glad they've done that. And that's why I'd always communicate to people. I'm always like, no, don't start in standard. It's not the normal game mode. The normal game mode is the challenge leagues.
Right.
It's funny. It's always been a pet peeve of mine because it's never going to change. This is the vernacular, right? But I hate calling it hardcore and standard because there's always a connotation that if you're a hardcore player, you're a better player. And I hate that. And that's coming from someone who's a purely hardcore player, right? I wish we would call it permanent and non-permanent death. But just because in this instance, someone would hear that they're doing something wrong or whatever. Because I really wish that we didn't care at all what happened in standard and hardcore in terms of affecting the economy, right? Because I feel like that will sort itself out. It's about making the challenge league experience the best it possibly can, because that is, like Ziggy's saying, that's where people, seems like people start.
Yeah. There. Sorry, standard players, I feel the same way, but
yeah.
Yeah. And I can't
deal with all of the runoff from the weird experiments in the challenge leagues.
Well, yeah, and like internals still exist, and you know, there's all these weird things going. You know, legacy items are all down there and stuff. So I feel like they're kind of like that right now. So it is kind of the Wild Wild West, and so we don't want to forget about them, but I can't make it the primary concern. And that's in the past when there's been something that's been really wrong with the challenge league. I get so agita about it because if this is their first experience, and they can't accomplish this thing. Yeah, that really...
I feel like the improvements that I want are the same improvements that most standard players would want. It's just that people are always listed online if they're online, and offline if they're offline, and that they can trade cross instances and just the more minor things like that. I don't think most standard players really need the integration of these third-party software or asynchronous trading or anything like that, really. Maybe asynchronous would help some standard players because it is hard to catch people online, I guess. But yeah, I think most of what we're talking about is for the newer players in challenge leagues.
Yeah, no, I definitely agree. And I think if they do some of these things with that in mind, I feel like it'll keep people happier longer. And even if they transition to standard, well, they know if they want to have this cool new experience, they just play the challenge league, which is what GGG wants anyway, right? Because at the end of the day, GGG wants to make money from us playing. You know, like I hope people out there, if you're watching this, that you buy some stash tabs, right? Because that's how we get the cool things. And you know, if you want a cool new trading system, buy some stash tabs, then put your 2 cents in that, man, I'd buy even more stash tabs if I could trade, if trading was easier and that type of thing. So I think that GGG is clearly doing it. It's in their interest to have this done because it seems like it's affecting everyone, like you're saying, even people in standard at this point, they want some of this stuff done. So
I'm interested, if you guys don't have like a major new topic to bring up, to have a bit of a vote on some features that you guys would either like to see or not like to see in the game. And you guys can feel free to suggest certain features as well and call a vote for them. So let's start with the easy one, right?
okay,
so let's say cross-instance trading. How do you guys feel about that? Mors?
I actually kind of think that that's... not something I care about at all. So I would put that as no at all. Because I think that seeing people in town... I think that's wasted development, personally, for me. I understand it can be annoying, but we have hideouts now and stuff like
that. Yeah, like, we have a pretty good system. I was kind of going to say yes, but you've actually kind of swung my vote a little bit, because we get to see people's cool hideouts, and without a reason to go to people's hideouts, then GG's not going to sell their hideout MTX. What's the point of hideouts? Like,
right.
So you might have actually swung my vote.
Well, same with me, because I was actually thinking the same thing. But then right when you said, I started thinking about it. I'm like, wait, well, it's just kind of wasted development time. That won't really solve anything as it is right now, I don't think.
It's a minor convenience at best, and negative impacts to the feel of community in the game. Like, I love in a race when everyone's running through the town at the start.
Yes. Like, yes. Yeah. Love that.
To lose some of that trading, I guess, might actually be a little sad. It's not that big a pain in the ass to go to someone's hideout, really.
It's actually quite lovely if they have a nice hideout.
Yeah. I get to see so many cool hideouts, and a lot of the times I enter a hideout and there's a bunch of those naked exile dudes standing around me in a giant circle jerk. And that's
staring.
It's an experience. It's you can't get that anywhere else.
Haunting.
Well, there might be some sides for that. So I guess I'll say no then. Is that three no's for that?
That's three no's. Oh, wow.
I did not expect that. Well, I thought that would be like the easiest thing. We'd all just be like, yeah, sure.
Well, can I have a caveat? If somehow I'm in game and you're on your phone or the website and you can click yes to trade, like, we're still trading. That's the type of asynchronous trading that I
That's a separate vote. So I guess we'll bring that up now.
Okay,
fine. Asynchronous trading. So allow me to explain that before we vote on it then. Asynchronous trading in that you can trade with either, I guess you can accept or send people offers via the website and in-game. Maybe like a phone app or something like that.
Right. And maybe even GGG doesn't develop the app. They just have the tool. Someone else makes the app for your iPhone or whatever. But yeah, but so yes.
Third party. Yeah, yes.
Yeah, so yes, I'm definitely in favor of that.
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of other tools that exist for other games that exist on your phone, and people use them a lot, and people really enjoy them, and it makes sense.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think I'm a pretty decent yes for asynchronous trading, even though it's kind of the same issue of what I was saying, cross-instance trading. Like, it is essentially cross-instance trading in another form, right? Like, you're trading, you could be in your hideout and use the website to accept a trade, right? Like, or use your phone. Maybe you have your phone set up next to you while you're playing the game. You don't leave your hideout to do a trade. So we will lose a little bit of going into people's hideouts. So at that point, maybe cross-instance trading becomes, like, if you've got this, why not have cross-instance trading too? Like, it would make sense to have it. So even though I voted no for that, I'm still going to vote yes for this, even though it would probably result in me not getting the desired outcome for the last vote.
Well, see, and now you swung me back, because if it was part of it, I would agree. Like, for instance, I started using Justice League Pee-wee Whisperer, which I don't know if you've used or scene or whatever, where it pushes a text to your phone, and when somebody whispers you in game, just put the whole message. So like, if I'm watching TV in the other room, I can leave this open, and someone's like, hey, I'd like to buy your, you know, chaos ring of swirling for 25 gas, and I'm like, yeah, and I get up and run in here and drink the trade and back to the TV, and like, that's great. And I made at least 5, 6, 7, 8x this league that I would not have made in previous leagues, because I didn't have the Pee-wee Whispers. I feel like if we're getting to the point where we're resorting to those things, something like that helps some of that stuff. Even though it's not, you know, I have to be at the computer to do something or whatever. There's still the person to person. It's just helping us a little bit with some quality. Like, if you're at work, like, people at work are automatically out. Like Hellman. Hellman can't trade when he's at work, etc. So I feel like if he could trade a little bit, he'd be a little more engaged, instead of being like, well, I'm done with the league because I'm back.
I think we all want this, but it does kind of go back to our earlier point that they need to implement these things slowly, one by one, because if everyone is making 7 to 8 extra results per league, then that's going to have a big impact on gearing and crafting and all of those things that we talked about in this show. So it is something that needs to be done cautiously, because even a change like that, which can be seen as just purely a convenience trade, has a big impact on the economy, because there is a lot more trade happening on. Sheer volume will change the economy.
Well, I think that's why I've been so binky about it. I think maybe you are just a little bit too, because we perceive it has to be done slowly and steadily. The fact that it hasn't been going on for the past year, right? If every league they want to do one small change, well, we're already three leagues later, and not much has happened, so that we know it's going to be three more leagues before we get to the meat, right? Of
yeah, that's the thing. Like, if they had have been every league doing some sort of change,
just tiny.
Yeah, they have done a few little things, like a few little API improvements and stuff like that, but not actually like one thing each league. Like, if that had been happening, I doubt we'd even be having this show. Like,
no, I don't think so. I think
we'd be like, oh, cool, I'm satisfied with this. This has been a good change, or this has been a bad change. We'd be talking about the changes, you know, in our regular shows. We wouldn't be having a show dedicated to trading.
Yeah, this has definitely come up for the lack of changes.
Yeah, just because it's been so long now without any real significant changes. Well, yeah. We are on the verge of getting some, so hopefully they're starting this trend now.
I mean, with your idea, I just want to be able to make a trade while I'm in the shower. You know, if I get a little, you know, my S5 is waterproof, I'm like, oh, trade, cool, 2X, thanks. That was the best shower. Because I can't necessarily run out of showers. Yeah.
As long as there's a checkbox for not being able to trade with people while they're in the shower, because I don't want
No new trades.
Safety.
No new trades. All right, what's the next one?
Okay. So, all right, that was a yes for that one then, three yeses. So the next thing was the integration of listing buyouts on items and tabs in-game. So basically, instead of going to an external application, you can right-click on the tab, right-click on the item, and add a buyout. And ZiggyD implements that as part of their own system. It automatically creates a shop thread, and it's automatically passed by POE trade.
It makes sense. We have it already, just outside of the game.
That's really it. I would be curious, is that something that would be very hard? That's the what I always hate, that we don't have just a GGG person here to be like, no, that's stupid. That would take us 50 million hours to do that, and here's why.
Yeah, we have to accept a certain amount of armchair development here, because we're like, oh, that would be easy.
No, I don't think any of this would be easy.
The application in the game, can't they?
Yeah, no. The game wasn't easy, there's definitely armchair developing and opinions going on.
Well, and it's funny, from using acquisition, sometimes people come to my stream and I'll put something in the 25 chaos tab and they'll go, are you out of your mind, Mors? And I'll say, well, actually, this is now the 12 chaos tab because I slowly lower prices over the league for things. But if I change the name of the tab, acquisition, maybe it does now. Before, if you change the name of it to 12 chaos, you had to then go back into acquisition and change the buyout. Like another time. So it was just like, rather than every time I change the buyout, I know I change it in acquisition to this, and then I never, it's just not reflected on my tabs in the game, which of course can lead to you mislisting things. So if GGG could handle it, so it's all done on their end, I think that would be amazing. But I'm so in favor of that, but I can't believe that would be easy to do just based on it.
They should only be in premium stash tabs. I'm joking. Totally joking.
No, I, you know what? I'm in favor of stuff like that. Like, it is, and you know, this is where I'm probably a snob since I'm a Diamond supporter, but it's like, you know, it doesn't make me better than anybody. I just feel like I have a little bit more right to be like, why is this not happening? Because I've ponied up and been like, I want to play this game for 5 or 10 more years. Like, I'm not doing it times. I'm not doing that every expansion. That was a one-time thing. But I just mean, I've paid my $50 a year to play PoE for the next 10 years. And I hope that people would understand if they gate things behind that. It seemed to be a very good response to the flavor of the month MTX, right? And so as long as they say, look, we're going to make it so it's easier to do stuff with acquisition, but it has to be a premium tab. That's just to fund the development. That's what we had to do. I think if they're upfront about it, I don't know. I'd be the first person on Reddit with my sword out as a white knight, chopping down the people. Because I tell them to shut up.
I think as long as they had like a tab or something that you could trade with, and then you could buy more, I would be fine with them selling stuff like that. Like, I honestly think, like, on a slightly different topic, that GGG could be doing so much more with MTXs. Why don't they sell an MTX skin for every new skill they release at the time they release it? Why don't they sell stuff based on meta? And Chris recently said, like, maybe we should be doing that. We thought you guys would have a problem with that. I'm like, no, make money. What the fuck?
Yeah.
We don't like the Razor MTX because that was jarring, right? Like, that was bad. I'd rather them sell out in the vein of the game. That's
why I think they won't be doing that again.
No. That was, they learned. No, and that's why. That was a test. I appreciate that. That's one thing I'll say about GGG. They do get it right eventually, right? Like, that's one reason I'm, for however much I might complain, I'll still be here tomorrow. I might yell today, but I'll come back tomorrow because I feel like it will get resolved. So, and it's next.
Three yeses.
Okay.
Right?
All right, that was good. Three yeses for that, I think. Yeah, yes, with the caveat of, like, not if it costs them, like, triple, like, 3 years worth of budget to do it or something, right? Obviously. So the next one, then, is the flip side of that. Peewee trade integration into GGG's website and or, I guess, they're into the game in some fashion. So having a tab you can open up and browse items in-game as well. So the flip side of that, essentially.
I'm going to say no.
Interesting.
I'll explain why.
I'll come back to you after Mors says, and we'll.
I guess I would want to know how it was done, right? Like, if it was something where it's like you click the bazaar button, and there's like, it just feels like there'd be too much. That I would just say no, just because I feel like the amount of effort required instead of just making their own system would be prohibitive, right? Integrating a thing and making it fit. Okay.
You've given me an interesting thought that maybe we'll take a step back for a sec first and separate this out into two votes, maybe. What about just literally taking the site, hiring the guy, and putting the site, POE Trade, on the Path of Exile website? So instead of when you click shops, instead of it going to a list of shitty forum threads that you're never going to get anything done in, it actually just brings up like that. Like, there's basically a shop button that goes to POE Trade on the GGG website. So it's not a third-party site.
I'm in favor of something like that. Whether or not they would do it, I think making the GGG experience better is what we would all want. Right, that would be in the vein of shops are better and it's easier to search. Like, there's all these options because GGG, like, even the search button in GGG's forums are awful. I was trying to find a post I made in a race forum. I couldn't find my post. I knew what the title was. I couldn't find it. So, like, there needs to be a little bit of love for the forum. I think they said, didn't they say they were doing something with the BB code something, words, buzzwords? I feel like I remember Chris saying something about the forum getting a bit of love at some point. Sorry, waba.
I mean, the website is one of the things that attracted me to the game initially, and I would love to see more active use out of it, and that would encourage people to put things on there a lot more, not even just in trading, but if the website is more efficient in what it does, and if it's actually updated with things, or if you could, like, okay, one of the most ridiculous things is trying to go to the Path of Exile website and find which base is best, right? Because then you have to go through and scroll through this long list of items, and it's not easy to do. And I'd imagine if you could just while you're doing that, just making the website better in general and including something like a tool like PoE Trade into it, because it would make sense to be like, instead of titling that button shops, you title it shop. And then it's just like, what do you want to search for? Boom, here you go. Here's everything that's listed. I think it's... So this kind of comes back a little bit to the fact that what Mors is saying, he doesn't want to be, snobby or anything. But man, like, I don't want players in the game that are just like, well, I just want everything to be done for me. I like effort because I will put that effort into the game. So that's why I would say not in the client, but on the website. Because with that, I'd imagine there'd be an overhaul to the website.
So the amount of extra effort you want players to have to do is just to open up the web browser and bring it up over the top of the game? Because that's, like, essentially the difference between having an in-game and on the website.
Well, if someone doesn't have a second monitor there anymore. No, I'm joking. I'm totally joking. No,
but... second monitor players should have a better trade experience. Yeah. You heard it here first.
Yeah, so... yeah, I mean, just an action... Like, more active use of the website, I think, would be good. Because then, we all use Reddit all the time. Right? Like, what if we just went to GGG for all the news posts? Their website. That's my thought.
Well, that topic right there could fill up an entire show, probably, a little bit. I don't know what Ziggy thinks about that.
So, like, to me, though, that I don't understand that argument, because to me it's just like a question of leveling the playing field. There might be some players that only want to look in-game, they don't want to look on the website. They don't have access to that trade system. Like, to me, to have that system in-game where you click a button and that the exact same thing that's on the browser, in the browser, opens up in-game, I can't see a reason why you wouldn't want to have that. So I'm a yes for both of those, hands down. Yeah. I think if they're going to go this route of implementing these things in the game, presuming that, then I'm a yes for implementing it in that fashion, just straight up.
What if it just took you automatically to the website, you know, clicking a hyperlink?
Click a button and it opens a website? Well, that would be a decent medium, I guess, yeah. And it'll probably save some
development. Doesn't that already happen with the shop? If you go to buy points, if you go to buy, it takes you to the website. That's kind of part of the
reason. That's a decent precedent for how they could do it. Yeah, that could work fine. Yeah. I mean, it'd be nice to have in the game as well, but
sure.
Like realistically, they're not going to implement the exact same system as PoE Trade in-game. They would do something that makes more sense in-game. But this is kind of a hypothetical, just to see functionality-wise what we would want to see in-game. Okay, interesting. So then, what about the idea, and this is something that GG brought up, how do you guys feel about the idea then of being able to list an item in your stash tab? This is kind of like a weird crossover, but this is what GG was suggesting a while ago. Being able to like list an item in a certain stash tab of, let's say, I want to get 10 cows for this item, and then someone either in-game or via the website is able to offer an amount on that. So either they offer the 10 chaos or they offer 8 chaos, and then you come back in the morning or whatever and you see in-game or on the website that listed offer, and you can either accept it, and then either the trade should happen automatically, I'd imagine, between the players once that accept happens. So there's still that kind of back and forth, but it's done in-game or website. How would you guys... Would you guys like to see that in the game?
Is the currency held? Like,
how do you mean?
Like, so, yeah, that's me. So,
I see what you're saying. It would have to be, yeah.
Yeah, so, if you're listening for someone for 10 chaos, and I say, oh, I want to offer 8, am I then, is that currency held that currency until you log on?
Yeah, and like, accept? Grayed out or something like that to not be
touched. Which I think that, could be kind of problematic, because someone might not ever log on if you have your currency locked.
You could put you would have to have like some sort of timer-based system.
12-hour like, timeout, 24-hour timeout.
The next 12 hours, they can accept this, otherwise you get currency back.
Yeah. That would be. But do you want to lose your currency for 12 hours?
Well, I mean,
you're not going to end up with the item?
Yeah, like, a lot of the time, if not, what happens now when you whisper someone, right, if they're AFK, you're like, even if it says they're going to be back in 5 minutes, a lot of the time, I'm just going to be like, I'll go on the next person. I guess that would still happen to an extent. But if there was an item you really did want, and maybe they were going to log on because they sleep opposite hours to you, like you're literally asleep when they're awake, then it would be nice to be able to have that option, I guess, to get that rare item that has the exact stats that you need.
Right, 20-29 fire res, which is what you need exactly. Yeah.
Now I'm at like weakness capped.
Right. Well, to me the interesting part is everything you're kind of suggesting, and there might be more. It's just interesting to me because I feel like a lot of it is, if there was some type of integration where you can click, because right now people don't use the official website messages, I think, as much as they could. I always check mine when people, because I do get people being like, "Hey,
I'm like 400 messages on the website."
right. So, if there was a way that they kind of bridged the systems, so people knew they could rely on, like, because I'm going to say mailbox, and I think there are people out there who are against the mailbox, too. And I will say I'm against MMOing PoE, because I think it's happened a little bit with, escort missions and master missions. I'm harping on the same topic that I don't like, but I feel like there's something they could do where you would be alerted. Someone sent you a message for looking for an item, and it would just pop up as a whisper in-game, right? Because it's like system message like they do when you win. I don't know if you guys have ever won something in a 1 week race, but just it's from the system. You've won wings and you click it and then it's in your inventory. So I feel like there's things there that they could do. So I'm definitely in favor of it, as long as it's I'm very conscious about the money it costs to get stuff done, because that's the big thing is they spend money on what brings the most bang for the buck. Because I'd rather have a better challenge league and a little bit of trading done.
Well, that's why we voted no for cross-instance trading, because we didn't feel the development costs were worth it. So that's you can vote that way if you don't think it'd be worth the investment.
No, I do. That's what I'm saying. I do think it'd be worth it. I just Whatever the smartest way to do it is always my caveat, I guess.
Yeah, well, this is kind of like an opposite choice to implementing PoE trade and acquisition into game or into the browser, is to have a system like this. Like, this is the alternative, essentially.
Right, right, right. They serve the same sort of, and I'd be totally in favor of it. If it worked for them, then yeah, great.
I definitely thought that the website was more integral when I first started playing the game, because it seemed so cool, right?
I think it used to. It definitely used to.
We used to have applications that would, you know, like little stash tab list of things, scan the stash tabs and show them up and stuff like that back in beta to show your chaos recipes and stuff.
It was some Chrome app is what I had in Chrome that did. It would, and it would find alks. At least mine would tell me where I can.
I remember what that was called, that application. But just like an old application that just doesn't exist anymore. It's crazy, right?
Right. Well, like the PoE trade, how many PoE? There's been 6 or 7 PoE trades.
Yeah, it's funny to think that, right?
Right, right. So I think I'm very happy that PoE trade is still around, because I would not be happy about PoE if it wasn't around.
Bound down.
Yeah, thank you. You're the best.
I really ought to get on and donate to him. He's got a donate button, right?
I appreciate you.
He doesn't, DJ Gallant, he doesn't take donations anymore, because I gave him $5. I think what is now, like 19 months ago. And I said, you guys should go give $5 to PoE Trade if you use it. And somebody was
he's not paying. He deserves to make some money off us.
Well, he must be making money from ads or something where he doesn't need donations. I don't know. Doesn't make sense to
me. Hopefully he does, because I'd imagine there's going to be, especially as the game gets more players, there's going to be more costs involved with it.
Yeah, I'll just improve the API for showing offline online players. Then that's going to be
Is there another one?
That's my list of ideas. If you guys have another suggestion that you would be interested in hearing a vote on, please do feel free to bring it up. But that's the ones I wanted to hear your best thoughts on.
Well, I don't really have a suggestion, but I do kind of have a final thought. But when it comes down to it, how far can we actually go with the barter system? Can it stay as the mainstay?
I love barter. And in the future, if we do have all these things implemented, I'm going to look back on it fondly and miss it. But sadly, I think, like many of the changes that have happened to PoE, that this is probably essential for the game's future. For its future success. If we want this to be a game that's around for another 10 years, which I strongly do want it to be, then I think that this is stuff that needs to happen, as sad as it is. Like, I miss the slower paced gameplay of old school PoE, but I don't want to go back to that. Like, I can be nostalgic about these things without thinking that they are a good thing for the game right now. And yeah, I miss, I miss that old searching Chrome application. I miss the days before Mastercrafting, even though I think Mastercrafting is good for the game overall. I think this is another one in that, this long list of the future.
Yeah. Well, and it's interesting that I think bartering could still work. You just need more participation than the people who play PoE right now are willing to put up. When there were 10,000 of us in closed beta, it worked fantastically. It worked decent enough. Then when it was smaller but open beta and we had PoE trade, it worked really great. And now it's gotten so much larger, we're having problems with it. And I think the big issue is basing anything off the D2 system, which they kind of did, which I find interesting. It's like they're leaving out that which shall not be named, the website of I shall not say its name, which was so integral in making that barter system work.
Yeah.
Right? Like, that's what people leave out. Why did it work? Because there was a third-party site that facilitated it. The entire purpose of that site was to make it work, much like PoE Trade is right now. Why does bartering work in PoE? Because of PoE Trade. It's only...
I think people forget the fact that Diablo 2 had a separate currency created by a third-party website in order to facilitate trading.
Right, exactly.
And so, one of the great things about Path of Exile is just our currency is our crafting system, which is one of the things that most of us love. Probably all of us.
No, and I think if these things are improved, you will see less of a reason to do this other stuff. Like in other facets of the game where people were doing things that perhaps weren't so above board, GGG has streamlined the game. Like, the leveling process is much easier than it ever was. You don't really need, it's very obvious where you need to go. I mean, well, maybe to a super new player, maybe not. But I mean, it's very quickly you can tell, oh, this is the direction I need to go now, because they've sort of, they've shooted you, you're in the tunnel to the get to the boss. And so these improvements, I think, benefit them on multiple fronts, which is clearly why they're doing it. So
I think that if these sorts of changes that we've talked about do happen in the future, though, that it, they can't be done by themselves. Like changes to the master system, changes to crafting need to happen, because otherwise they are just going to become obsolete. Like, you know, we've already seen less and less actual crafting happen over time, and it's getting to the point now where I'm like, I really miss crafting, and I'm like forcing myself to play Spellbound, which is, that's fine to that people like have the option to do that sort of thing, but it would be nice that if a part of the core game experience was also to do some crafting. So rebalancing and potentially major rebalancing to a crafting system may have to happen in the future if significant trade improvements are made.
Yes, I wish mirrors were actually 10 times more common now that Eternals are gone. I wish mirrors, to me, for an endgame player, that would be, even just for a challenge league, it's like, oh, I'm actually, I have a pretty good chance of finding a mirror for 5x, right? Because they're, well, I, okay, I only know hardcore prices, but they're right. 50x, whatever they are, 60x. So it means for 5 or 6x, I can get a mirror. And then it's like, oh, well, all right, I'm going to get maybe one or two mirrors a league. What am I going to mirror? Like, what great item out there is going to be to mirror? And then that really facilitates more crafting, because then people are going to YOLO with their X on the potential, hey, you know, if I hit attack speed, I'm going to get 7 or 10, 20, 40 people to mirror my item. And so there's this interesting dynamic. And I don't think they'll do it, because it would affect the permanent leagues. I hate saying that, but that's my impression. You know, they would be nervous about the fact that they've, you know, whatever,
10 well, times. Removing the Eternal Orb was drastic.
Right, but they didn't delete it from the game. Right, well, it still exists.
Yeah. Yeah, so
but yeah, I see what Mors is saying. Like making mirrors 10 times as common, they're going to filter back into standard where there are already mirror worthy items. Whereas right. in a challenge league, they have, those have to be crafted, and that promotes crafting. And right. I like for me to just ignore standard in this case and just be like, this would be awesome for the core game, which is those challenge leagues. Then yeah, I'd love to see mirrors 10 times more common. I think that's a good idea.
Something like that, especially with Eternals gone, it's so much, it promotes the. Now you would never do that, right? Why would you YOLO X? You know, I mean, I still do it, and I'm sure some people might still do it, but there's no real pressure to do it. Versus if you hit your thing, now there's this real, you've got back to that, why did people gamble in the first place? Because if you hit, holy moly, there's nothing, because you couldn't master anything on. So I feel like if they thought outside the box a little bit, it could be really cool. And you know what? If it busts, because, I mean, maybe it's a terrible idea that I've had. Well, it was one challenge league, and we're out of it. You know, after 2-3 months, it's over. So,
you know, go ahead. Oh, I was about to say, it would also change the, you know, the definition of what is mirror worthy. Because right. also, if that price comes down, you know, that will have, like, exactly like you're saying, that will have a profound effect on the challenge league, because I find myself at the end of this, you know, in the middle of this challenge league where I'm crafting because there's really nothing on the market, like for what I need and for what I want. And the things that do exist are so like absolutely overpriced in my opinion, you know, and if mirrors were more common, I could, you know, foreseeably been like, oh, and that would bring down a lot of things that would bring down, that would encourage more trading in the sense, or more currency to be generated for players in the terms of like mirror fees and everything else. So I like that idea.
Here's an idea that I have really out of left field, and I kind of fully expect and want you guys to shoot this down horribly. Okay. But so Mors, I'm counting on you.
Okay.
What would Path of Exile be like where you could craft affixes on gear that were higher than what could potentially drop? So let's say there was another tier of affix that was attainable only through exalting, only through alking and things like that. Insert okay. destroying of my idea here, because I can't think of what the problem with that is.
So wait. So I want to make sure I understand. So you're saying, so if yeah. I alk a ring,
yes.
it can get 89 life, whereas the current max is 79. And it only yeah. happens if you alk or transmute or alt or whatever.
Yeah.
Now,
and obviously, it would be significantly rare because it'd be like the top tier stat.
Right. So if a ring dropped and it was crap, but I cast it, would that then have the chance to roll crazy stats?
Yeah.
Okay.
I certainly promote the use of those crafting currencies.
I mean, I'm in love with that, and I can just hear people screaming in, you know, like Alderaan getting exploded by that, because that's not what they want. I would love that. To me, that's on the order of fuck masters, get them out of the game. That's such, to me, that's a great, I've never thought of anything like that. I love that idea, but I just have that sinking feeling in my stomach of despair that nothing like that would ever. Well,
I can't think of what people like. I that's what I imagine too. I imagine that exploding Alderaan. I was hoping that it would come from me, because I can't think of right now, and I don't know if any of us are going to be answering the question, what is the problem with that idea? There must be, like, it feels like there must be some really big problem with that idea, but I can't think of what it is.
Time for me to shoot it down.
Okay.
I'm joking. I think it's a wonderful idea. If you guys disagree, tell us in the comments below.
This is where the comments / Reddit
jumps
on us. So that's the most horrible idea. Chase us with pitchforks out of the community.
I think that's actually a great idea. That's a fantastic idea. Both of those ideas were really good, because they would both encourage crafting. And if it's easier to craft, you're more kind of inclined to trade, because you want the crafting materials.
Well, I'm a little more optimistic. Well, it'll be interesting to hear what people say about that, because within the context of what we talked about earlier, of masters being a little worse than what they are now, mm-hmm. so that you're crafting that not quite good enough gear with masters, but then you can craft that way better than what you can drop gear. And I guess, like, the problem, I guess, that some people might bring up is that it would take away from drops a bit, right? Like, drops would be a little less exciting, because you don't have that potential of dropping that perfect item. But you still have the potential of dropping, like, that insane item, right? Like, with the current tier 1 affixes, and you just can't get those tier 0 affixes.
Well, it also gives a player a choice, like, oh, well, am I going to go with this dropped mirror-worthy item, or am I going to try to craft my own? Because I can get double more health. Right. Well, I'm going to go ahead and end it with that. Thank you guys very, very much. If you guys have any other thoughts, you know, anything you want to add before we
go. I think that's a pretty good ending point. I'm very curious to hear what people say about that last idea and about a lot of what we've discussed in general.
Yeah. Well, Ziggy, where could people find you?
Well, you can pretty much just Google Ziggy D. As one word, Ziggy D. I'm on Twitch and YouTube, and on Twitter. I'm on all of those places, and just Googling my name will find you those things. I'm simple. I don't need to go through the full shout-outs.
And yes. Mors.
So when you Google Ziggy D, right, because you're a Ziggy D fan, then what you type into your browser is Mors Rage NG. I know that's unfair. That's not like that. No, if you just Google Mors, you could find me. I have Twitter. I have YouTube. I don't know why you'd go to those places. Sometimes people like them. I'm not sure. I upload things there. I couldn't tell you why at the end of the day. I hope you get something out of it. If you run into someone,
stream, and you've been streaming a lot these days.
Mostly stream. If you see something about Cybrix, you know, I don't know. I don't think that's me. You know, people say it's me. It sounds like me. It's this exact voice. But I mean, no, it's nothing like that. So just stop on by, say hello, be like, are you that guy from Crip Stream raging that time? Yeah, you know, I may be. And that's why I'm here with Ziggy D, because he's making me happy and ready to play some PoE. So there you go.
And don't Google my name. Do not Google my name. Even though you will find me, but don't Google my name. But yeah, guys, thank you again very much. Episode 14, Trade Chat. We'll see you guys later. Bye-bye.
Thanks for having us on.
Yeah.